Sustainability, from Molok's perspective, is like our founder Maria used to say, what are we trying to do? What's our purpose? And our purpose is to change the world and make it a better place. When you think about sustainability in the forefront of those thoughts, it becomes really important from a social conscience perspective of our company that we're doing something that is important to us, important to the residents throughout the world, and important to the world itself. So Molok was founded by a gentleman in Finland whose name is Veikko Sali. And Veikko was a mechanical engineer turned entrepreneur that was very good at building things. And subsequently he was involved with building a bunch of hotels, sports centers, restaurants, that type of thing through Scandinavia. One day he was challenged, as the story goes, by the appearance of garbage in one of his hotel sites in Finland. And he got to thinking about that, and I think with the help of his wife Anya, they came up with the concept of going semi-underground with the garbage, which brought a whole host of advantages to it, from the scope of space saving, aesthetics, animals, odors, all that type of thing.
In 1991, Veikko, together with his daughter Maria, turned the semi-underground waste concept into a business. In the first 2 weeks, the company sold 40 containers to the local road administration before it had even produced a working model. They named the company Molok, after the mythical god with a mouth like a bottomless pit.
At some point, the concept of coming to North America with the Molok model came into view, and I wasn't part of the family at that point, but in discussion with Maria and Veikko, it was decided Maria would come over here to Canada, and she did that with a one-year-old daughter, as a single mother, started this company up, and just had so much drive to make things happen with it. And it takes a certain character and a certain personality and a certain drive to be able to do that. Finnish people, as I've learned, being married to one for that many years and being many times in Finland, are driven by something that they call sisu. Easiest way to describe it is a stubborn determination against all odds. And Maria, I think, accentuated the word and the concept of sisu very strongly. And failure was nothing that ever came into her mind.
Well, it was like her baby. It was a part of her life for so long, and it was the whole reason her and I came to Canada, or a big part of the reason, I guess. She started with just this little tiny office in her closet in Mississauga, and now it's this huge company doing these amazing things, and it was really important to her as a woman and a business leader and an environmentalist. It was a huge vision.
Maria ran Molok North America until March 2018, when she passed away. Her daughter, Mona, now co-owns the company, along with Maria's husband, Mark, who stepped up from VP of operations to take over as president. In 2019, Molok North America will be marking 20 years of operation and 1 year since its founder's death. But it's clear that Maria's vision for the company lives on.
She always did things, sometimes in an unusual way that you kind of thought like, well, that's not so conventional, but it always ended up working out. And I say that in like every aspect of her life too. She didn't like the trodden path so much, and she just kind of did what she wanted, and she got that from her dad too. He's the exact same way. She taught me independence and to really stand for what you believe in. She taught me the value of stubbornness. She was very stubborn in her ways, yet very open-minded as well. So I think I've gotten a lot of her personality traits, which I'm super grateful for, because she was so loved and still is.
So the vision, the drive, the dream, the passion that she had for Molok and for how she wanted it to change the world really came into play throughout her leadership in this company. And it's her drive and her leadership that set the stage for how we think as a global company and the success that we've had.
I believe our reputation in the industry is one of a leader, one of creativity. In some industries, they view companies as disruptors. You know, it seems to be in the Internet of Things, every business is a disruptor. We were a disruptor 27 years ago, and we continue to disrupt the industry. We're changing the way the individual views containment systems, the way architects, developers, and the service companies do business.
The traditional waste model in North America, and particularly in Canada, where we have most of our experience, if you consider it in the sense of a triangle, where the waste collection companies, the experts in the industry, are at the top, the municipalities, which govern waste collection, are kind of at the middle of the triangle, and the people, the residents, are at the bottom of the triangle. The municipalities look upward to the waste collection companies on how things should go with regards to waste collection, recycling, organics diversion, that type of thing. Then they push it down to the residents. We've been fortunate enough to take that triangle and turn it upside down. We're putting the people, the end users, the people who use Molok containers at the top. They're the decision makers. They're the people who use the system that want to get the most out of it. And they're driving that downward through the municipalities into the big waste companies in North America. And that's been really successful for us because that's the voice. That's the voice of the people. And the people are educated. They understand what's going on in the world today from a sustainability perspective. They have a vision for what future they would like their children and their grandchildren to see. And that fits very well with the concept of Molok.
Today, Molok North America has installations in Canada from Halifax to Vancouver. It's also established containers in key U.S. cities and has launched a distribution partnership in Mexico. Where one Molok container pops up, others quickly follow. Because from the user to the property developer to the city, the advantages of the Molok container are immediately obvious.